SHIPMOOR is based on a numerical modeling tool developed in the 1980s. It was originally developed as a dynamic motion analysis tool to look at under-keel clearance of the brand new VLCC ships that had just started transiting the English Channel in the 1980s. It was UK government-funded research at the time, and it was validated against a wide range of physical models, and also full-scale measurements where available. In the late 1980s, it was adapted so it could be applied to stationary moored ships. By setting the ship speed to zero, the wave-induced vessel motions that are generated were effectively the same calculations. We continued to develop and validate that model against physical modeling tests, and also against field data collected at various locations worldwide, expanding it so it could be applied to a wide range of different ship types, complex wave conditions, and other scenarios. We then researched and included passing vessel effects, so that the models can also represent the impact of a ship passing the moored vessel. SHIPMOOR is well established in the industry, having been used by HR Wallingford in over 500 commercial projects over the last 40 years. Now we have integrated the existing set of fully validated and dynamic mooring analysis models and created the SHIPMOOR web tool. On the static analysis side of things, we carried out some very extensive hand calculations and compared those against the actual output of the model itself. Here is one graphic just showing that comparison with the lighter bars in the histogram representing the hand calculation values and the darker histograms depicting model output. And you can see that there is very good agreement there, give or take the rounding areas that are inevitable in the hand calculations. We use all the Orkhamf conventions and units. The forces and moments are calculated using standard SIG2 and Orkhamf coefficients. We use Euler's methods to iteratively solve the vessel's motions and its position, to give initial equilibrium position, mooring line pretensions, and the environmental loading. And we finally calculate the displacement line loads and verify those against hand calculations. It has been proven to be quite accurate, and we continue to validate every aspect of the software where we have an opportunity, or where physical model test is undertaking, or when we can measure full-scale ship mooring motions and mooring forces at berth. SHIPMOOR is an online portal that allows storing data which can be securely shared with industry partners. There is only one copy of a ship or berth to keep up to date. Ship data is entered only once based on the templates, modified sister ship, or by importing from existing files such as Excel. We work in conjunction with LNG Port Info web portal to pre-populate berth data. We can also receive change requests from mooring analysis users to help with keeping the data accurate and up to date. Here are some berth samples that are already available in SHIPMOOR. The mooring line data are pre-populated with manufacture catalog data. It is the same with fender data, but of course, in both cases it is also possible to enter custom-specific information. Using the 3D view enables users to easily see if something has been entered incorrectly. It's possible to make changes directly to the 3D objects, both master data and each mooring arrangement study, which allows testing various design scenarios. The mooring configuration is set up in the simplest possible way. The deck mooring arrangement is clearly visible. and this can help highlighting problems such as when mooring lines arrange on deck at incorrect angles. External conditions are clearly shown, again, to reduce potential input error. The calculations are submitted to the online server, and the result is displayed directly in the 3D environment, using color-coded representation of the tensions in the mooring lines, the loads on the mooring equipment such as hooks, and surface of the fender panels in contact with ship parallel body. A range of reports is available. Overview, detailed, wind limit, Orkumpf criteria, and batch calculations. The reports are displayed in the browser and emailed as PDFs. They give all the calculation details that the 3D view does not show. They are also easy to customize, and we are open to suggestions to improve existing reports or create new ones. Batch calculations are now testing multiple environmental conditions in one step. And, as you can see, the ship's movements are also represented on screen. When dynamic calculations are enabled, the Dynamic tab appears in External Conditions. It allows entering wind waves and swell. As well as the wind gust spectrum. After the static calculations are complete, and a satisfactory mooring configuration is found, the dynamic report is then requested. Here is an example with a single dynamic calculation, but it is possible to vary the external conditions and run a batch calculation with all these variations. Once the dynamic report request has been submitted, it is possible to access a status page that shows the progress and the parameters of the dynamic calculations. An email is sent with the link to the status page. The dynamic analysis is based on a 3-hour time domain simulation. Previously, it was not possible to carry out such task on the user's computer due to the required computation times and processing power. However, these calculations can now be done within minutes by using large numbers of high-performance computing units through Microsoft Cloud. You can see 200 high-performance cloud machines spooling up and starting the dynamic calculations. Another email is sent when the calculation has completed. Here we can see the dynamic calculation took 17 minutes to complete. The detailed dynamic report can then be accessed. The report is based on a 3-hour time series simulation. It is similar to the static detailed report, but it shows minimum, significant and maximum values instead of single static values. It displays the vessel motions and rotations. The ship manifold displacement, velocity, and acceleration. The load on the mooring lines. The force applied to the hooks on the jetty and dolphin. The force applied to the deck winches and mooring points. The fender's contact area, compression and reaction force, and the hull pressure. The full-time series is available from the status page or the detailed report PDF. The variations of ship motions, mooring line loads and fender reaction forces are shown for a 3-hour period. Specific events can be further analyzed by zooming in. For more information, please visit our webpage, shipmoor.com.